Welcome back to the mainframe tutorial part 2 of the mainframe ETL developer of our AQA. So as I said earlier, so now let's go ahead and see like first step. What is the first step that is required for an ETL developer to work on the mainframe or to understand the mainframe system, right? The first step is here. So we need to understand like how do I connect to mainframe. First thing is you need to have an emulator that needs to be installed on your respective work machine or workstation. So emulator is nothing but it's a software that gets installed on your respective window machine. So maybe you can request you can raise a ticket to the respective IT team, so they will be installing an emulator. So we have different emulator softwares that are available in the market or based on your project that gets installed. One is TN3270, Mocha, Hummingbird. So like this we have we have an IBM emulator. So like this we have different emulators that are available in the market, and it's based on the license and the company what they are using, right? The main purpose is to connect to the IBM mainframe system. For that we need any respective emulator. So presently what I am using is an Vista emulator, so just to connect to the mainframe system. And another thing is you need an IP address of that particular system, IBM mainframe, that you are going to connect. So if you ask me what are the different mainframe systems that we have in the market, so we have like IBM, HP and several others, but 90 to 95% of the market uses IBM mainframe. So this was the first system that was introduced a long time back, and it's been used from many years, right? So most of the companies, most of the banking domains or insurance or any other higher projects, I mean the big projects, that will they will be using IBM mainframes only, right? So first thing is you need an IP address to connect to that system, and you will be having a rack of ID and the password. So once once you get an access to the mainframe environment, you get a user ID and the password will be provided to you so that you can get connected to the mainframe. So and if you ask me what is the operating system that it uses, so it is a ZOS operating system, so we also call a zero downtime operating system. So unlike we have an Windows, we have an XP, we have a 7, we have a 10, right? So and also you have a Unix operating system, you have an Android operating system. So like this, in the same way mainframe itself uses one of the operating system that is known as a ZOS operating system. Whatever we work on mainframe, so it's all about the ZOS operating system. Now let's go ahead and see how do I connect to the mainframe system. Normally as I said, we need an emulator system that need to be installed, emulator software that need. So if you look at my desktop, so I can see like Mocha T1 3270. For Vista it says when I double click on it, it asks me for the IP address and everything. So I default added, so this will be the logon session of the initial logon screen, so where I'm going to connect it. So once I click on a command like TSO, so it gets connected to the mainframe environment. So here it's asked me for the enter user ID. So here I need to enter my user ID and then a login password. So right. So this is how I get connected to the mainframe environment. So in the same way, when you're working, when you wanted to access any file or a data from the mainframe system, this is the first step that you need to have. If you don't have, then you cannot access any data or you cannot see anything, right? So this is where we need that. So it based on the company or a project that you are working on, so based on that you can connect it. So now I'm clicking on user ID and password, so then it gets connected to the mainframe system. Now you can see like I'm connected to the mainframe environment. So this will be the first screen that you can see once you connect it to the mainframe environment. So we call this as a screens. Here everything is represented as a screen, right? If you are working on a Unix environment, it's all about the command, right? So you connect it to, in the same way, when you connect to, you will be logging using a PuTTY if you're working on a Unix environment. Even on a Windows, just you turn on your computer, just you will be seeing a Windows system, and then it's all about the GUI, right? And also you will be, if you're working or if you're using MS-DOS, as everything will be the, so the DOS command. Then the same way, just if you go to command and just if you work on this, you will be working on the different systems, right? So in the same way, so here also, so what do you do? So you'll be after connecting to the mainframe environment. So the first step that you can see is ISPF primary option menu. So okay, so here on this you can see the different options. So if you want to see the settings of it, so on the options, so this will be the command area where you can type the command or options. So here are the different options that you can select on what you want to work, and these are nothing but these are the different function keys. So that I will going to explain on this. Okay, so first let me go to a next screen. How can I change the next screen? Suppose here you have seen the option, right? If I select 0, if I type 0 and press enter, it will go to this particular screen. Okay, now I wanted to come back to the last screen that I was there. So how can I go to that? So here you can see the different function keys, right? F3 to exit. When I say F3, so this will exit from this particular screen and it will go to the home screen. F7 is a backward, F8 is a forward, that we will see earlier in the next videos. Plus F3, so yes, you have come back to the one step forward back screen, right? In the same way you have different screen, one view to edit, three utilities like foreground, batch and all those things. So you can see the different options that are there. So based on that you can create. Okay, so we'll be seeing more and more function keys going forward when we actually work on this file system. And also I have another tutorials where you can connect and see like what are the different if you want to understand in detail about this mainframe and environment, what is operating system and everything. So you have created a different playlist, just you can go and watch those videos. Okay, so once again thank you so much for watching this tutorial. Have a great wonderful day.